because they saw her?
Yeah.
There she is, there she is, there she is.
Elise and I were heading home for the night when we spotted a dog behind the rescue running around the train tracks.
That guy's gonna spook her this way. He's gonna spook her this way. He's walking towards her.
Is that the train guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, train guy.
Please spook her, please spook her this way. Please spook her this way. Please, 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 doggy, please, 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 please. Yes, Elise, she's coming.
Okay.
Chicken.
It's so scary when there are stray dogs running around the train tracks. If a train comes, they may not see the dog, so there's definitely a fear that this dog may get hit by the train.
Is she coming?
She's on the other side now.
It's okay, baby.
She's in a corner right there, too.
Oh, here she comes, here she comes. Oh, she's so cute. We might be able to corner her.
I was hoping that we would be able to start building some trust and he would start to calm down a little bit.
Yes, please, 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 doggy, please, 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 please. It's okay, baby.
Wow. But unfortunately, just the way that the dog was running around so frantically just goes to show how scared the dog really was.
No, don't be scared. We just want to help you. Don't leave. Come here, baby.
The closer we got to the dog, the further he would run from us. You never chase after a stray dog. You just make them run in the other direction.
Oh, I can see it. Look at her.
I think it's just so big of an outside space.
The dog moved down into an open field behind the train tracks, and it's not closed off in any way. I mean, there's a million places for the dog to run off to.
She's like, no one's even near her, and she's like, yeah. Totally frantic. No, no, she's leaving.
It's because we're here.
It's because we're here, yeah. But I think if we keep pushing her, she might completely leave. I'm gonna put canned food in a bowl, and then I'll try to walk over, and then if she bolts, I'm gonna walk away.
I took a bowl of wet food and put it into the field just to see if there was any interest in food, and then we could build a relationship that way.
All right, let's check the bowl tomorrow and then make another plan.
We are hoping that this dog stays in the area. That way we can try to catch him again when it's light out.
She's coming back, and now she's more in line with where, like, the bowl of food is.
So it's just a waiting game, and the plan is to check the bowl in the morning.
Well, at least it didn't get hit by a train, so that's a win.
So he's running in between all of these yards right now.
Elise called me and said she had spotted the dog that was running around the train tracks.
It's okay, baby.
In a business parking lot right around the corner from the rescue.
Well, keep me posted. I have to.
Okay, bye.
I was getting ready to come in, but unfortunately, my son was not having the greatest morning, so Mo and another VRC employee went over to help.
He ran in through here, and he's somewhere here.
I went out looking this morning for the dog again and ended up seeing him run into a yard, and I was able to find the manager, and he let us in to go try and catch him. Unfortunately, this yard was about 3 or 4 different compartments, all with huge wide openings. So one of the things that we were afraid of is that the dog was gonna try and run through the entire yard.
This may be the only way for us to catch him because he's in 4 walls.
There he is.
Oh,
okay.
There he is.
Okay, hello. All right, there's no exit from that yard.
Luckily, he ended up cornering himself on top of some metal beams in like the most perfect spot. So we were able to block off all the exits.
Hi. Yeah, Mo, come over this way. Maybe we can just do it right here. You're okay. Come on, it's okay. There you go. It's okay.
You always have to be very careful when a dog is backed up against something. You never know if they're gonna freeze or they're gonna try and bolt after you, you know, anything to get out of a scary situation for them. So we just kind of slowly walked up to him to see what he would do.
Hi. You're okay?
It's a little dog with a big attitude.
So this was a much different dog now that he was cornered in a yard than the previous night. This dog that we were seeing in the yard was definitely petrified. He was just kind of shut down, wasn't moving.
Oh, what a good doggy.
Hi, it's okay. You come here, it's okay.
All right.
He's gonna, yeah, he's gonna. You go. I'm gonna trick him right now.
Don't be quick with it.
Okay, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine, he's fine, he's fine.
There you go. Yeah.
It's okay.
He froze and we just kind of looped him. We were not expecting it to be like that.
There you go. There you go.
Good job, guys, good job.
We could have been securing Pigeon. Instead,
oh, should we name him Pigeon?
Yes.
Pigeon.
Pigeon.
I've always wanted to name a dog Pigeon.
Well, come here, we're just gonna go.
Come.
There you go. It's okay. There you go. Come here. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Come on. Let's go.
Hopefully, now that we've caught him and he's safe, you know, with a little decompression time, a little rest, you know, he'll get used to us and come out of his shell a lot more.
Come on. Good boy. Good boy. Okay. Thank you.
We have been checking the Lost and Found websites to see if anybody was looking for the dog we found running loose on the train tracks a couple of nights ago, and unfortunately have come up empty-handed.
About... Are you ready for this?
Yeah, Buford's always ready.
Come on.
Pigeon's personality is actually pretty spunky and fun.
Good boy, Pew-Pew.
Good.
He's very sweet and affectionate.
Buford, you like him?
He loves him. Look, he loves Pew-Pew. This is good body language.
You shoot.
We've already done some initial dog testing with Pigeon, just, you know, doing some introductions on leash and taking him for walks with other dogs.
We should let them loose. Do you want to?
Yeah, let's all put them out together.
So now we move on to testing him loose in our play yard.
Pew Pew, do you want to play? They look so funny together.
Look at them just run side by side with each other.
Oh my God, he loves Buford.
Look at him, he's a different.
He's so confident now.
He looks smaller.
Pigeon was really excited about Buford. Buford could care less because that's just who he is.
Good job, Buford.
Hey, tell him Buford. Tell him Buford.
There were a few times when Buford had to correct Pigeon and put him in his place, but Pigeon took it and they continued on being friends, and that's what we call like an appropriate correction.
You tell him that's inappropriate.
It's okay to let them work it out as long as it doesn't escalate into a fight.
Buford likes him.
Good job, Buford!
Pigeon did really well with his dog testing. We can consider Pigeon absolutely dog friendly.
Pigeon!
It's so funny to see Pigeon, this like happy little dog running around just because he was so intense when we tried to rescue him. And to see the transformation is really amazing. I'm really happy for him.
He loves Uncle Buey.
He's so dog friendly. He loves to play. And I know that we could have no problems placing him.